bodes well. Very good gates, like that. Fabulous gardens, knackered drive. Check this place out, it's unbelievable, isn't it?
Hi there, Drew.
How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
And you, mate.
What a pad.
Yeah.
Please, let's get on with it.
Come on in.
Oh, my word. So, what's for sale?
Bits and bobs.
OK.
Obviously, in the inside the main hall...
Not so much, but maybe.
Maybe.
Is it worth me asking?
Yeah, there's a PCC, maybe. You never know.
Basically, everything. That pair of benches?
No.
Club fender?
No.
That chair?
No.
That cabinet?
No.
Great. Should we go through there? Right, OK. Oh, my God.
Although it's frustrating...
Oh, my God.
Drew is revelling in his privileged access to a special collection that few people have ever clapped eyes on.
Look at that. Wow, a stone staircase as well. Oh, T, check it out. Oh, look at that.
Just to cover a radiator.
God, I've never seen the like.
I've never seen Drew like this. He's like totally bewildered.
Ooh,
it's like a kid in a sweet shop.
I think I'll need to have a bit of a lie down. This is the best house call I've ever had. It's better than most museums I've got.
Drew's seen some incredible pieces, but will he be able to buy anything?
So this is Nelson's room. We have lots of Nelson paraphernalia. My family was a chaplain to Nelson.
Oh, really?
And I'm all on ships and stuff.
I don't ask.
Possibly.
Yeah? All right,
possibly.
OK.
Possibly.
Nice little stick back. Nice bit of old paint. Crinoline stretcher, original legs, which is a rarity.
The Georgian stickback chair is in tip-top condition. Despite being 200 years old, there are no signs of repair. Just tiny traces of the original green paint. A prime example like this could fetch around £1,000.
What do you want for that?
I don't know, you'd have to give us a... You'd have to shout the price up on that. See if we're on anywhere near.
£450.
Would have thought a bit more.
How much more?
Another £200 more, I would have thought.
£650. All right. OK.
Yeah?
We found something really quite nice. There's a wonderful stickback Windsor armchair, really naively made, incredibly original. It's the most original one, bar one, I've ever seen. Now, these chairs have always, always been battered to hell and badly repaired and nailed together and stripped. That has, from the day it's been made, never had anything done to it, and I'll pay a premium for it, which I did at £650. I paid a premium for it. God, there's stuff everywhere. I mean, it's just an absolute joy to behold everything. This?
Yeah, it's got cobwebs on it. That's how long it hasn't been moved from.
This is the only exercise Drew gets moving chairs.
Yeah, right.
It's called chair aerobics.
Made from oak, which has been carved to look like bamboo, this 19th century chair is in the style of the master cabinet maker Thomas Chippendale. It could be worth around £600.
We found a sort of what I would say is a chinoiserie open armchair, faux bamboo with an upholstered seat. 19th century, not 18th, had a really hard life. It's been stripped, and when they chemically strip hardwoods like that, it opens the grain and you get little sort of cracks, and that's what happened to it all over it. But it's very, very beautiful to look at, and sometimes that's enough for me to buy it. What would you want for that?
No idea. Go on, you name a price again.
Shame it's 19th century, not 18th century. £300.
£350, kind of deal.
Three.
Is that the top?
That's
top
it.
Top of your
that's
lot?
It.
Yeah, go on then. £300.
Thank you. £300 for that chair. Happy with that. It's not worth a penny more. Just had to have it.
Having bagged a couple of excellent chairs...
God.
Drew's now eager to seek out more in the deeper recesses of Pepper Arden.
Cellar.
Blimey. Yeah, now you're talking. Oh, wine.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Hello.
Oh, blimey. Oh, look at those.
They're old boys, aren't they?
God, they're cool, aren't they?
It's a set of 9 very large wooden travelling trunks.
What a great collection. Do I want those? Do I need the hassle? They're absolute buggers to sell.
Are they?
Yeah. Well, it's a superb collection.
I think they've got William Webb on them. We used to have the house many, many years ago.
These steamer trunks would have been used for journeys by boat and train, harking back to a time when travel for the wealthy meant taking whole households along. Some of them belonged to William Webb, who owned the house back in the 19th century. They could be worth around £1,200.
See this one here with all these things on here? They would have had silver in it.
Oh, right.
Yeah, they've been sealed over the top there. See the seals?
Yeah.
So they didn't get broken, so they'd have, like, valuables and stuff in them.
Yeah.
And put them on trains. Steam and put them on trains. Yeah. Yeah, trains and boats, yeah. There's a whole collection from the previous owners of this house, so now you're adding really super authentic history to each one of those pieces. And as a collection, they've still got the wax marks on them where they'd have waxed both sides. So they've filled them up full of silver and porcelains, all their expensive stuff. And then the butler would have put two wax seals across it with a piece of string or a piece of paper between the two, and then they'd be locked. What would you want for the lot?
What would they be worth, about 150 each?
Can't figure out whether I want them or not. They look impressive there, but when you're trying to get rid of them, what would you want one for, you know? But they're very authentic. 800 quid. They're just tricky things.
Yeah, go on, 800 quid. I'll be happy with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What have I done?
Drew's been enthralled by the house and its contents. He spent nearly £1,800.
Today was sensational. It was incredible, exciting, frustrating, maddening, educational, and a really good laugh. It was good fun today. If all the items I expressed an interest in were for sale, which they're not, I would have bought every single one. I've never seen a collection of untouched, undocumented, historically important furniture in one house, and pretty much in one room. We'd have just spent every single penny we had.
I think he's got a good little haul. Been quite an education, really. I think Drew's been always fair with prices, so I was not going to bargain too much with him, but I think I've got good enough deals. It was really good to have some expert knowledge on all the pieces in the house.